Subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any updates from Technical Beings.
Hey guys, welcome to another video. Today we will see how to use sudo command in Linux. Sudo is basically used for giving admin rights to a normal user. So you have probably seen tutorials that use sudo for running administrative commands as root. However, when you try it, you get told your user ID is not in the sudo's file, the incident will be reported. But for developers, sudo can be very useful for running steps that require root access in build scripts. So in this video, we will see how to configure sudo access on Red Hat Enterprise Linux and CentOS, so you won't need to use su and keep entering the root password, configuring sudo to not ask for your password. So this will be a practical, so let's get started. I'll create a user first, user add Stephen, okay, and I will give a password to Stephen. Okay, so I'll just quickly have a look whether it is created or not. So once the user is created, his home directory is created in /home. So as you can see, the Stephen user is created. Now we will try to switch to Stephen user. And I will try to create a user, user add Jim. If you can see, user add Jim is not permitted to Stephen because Stephen does not have admin rights. So in this case, we will have to provide admin rights to Stephen. So let's see how it is done. To enable sudo for your user ID on RHEL, add your user ID to wheel group. So you have to add the user into the wheel group. And for adding that, the command is usermod -a, that is add G for group and wheel and your username. So coming back to root user, user modify hyphen add the group in wheel, which user? The user Stephen. So now this user is added into the wheel. So what is the next step? Now you will be able to use sudo when logged in under normal user ID. You will be asked to enter the password for your user ID when you run a sudo command. So let's see whether now Stephen is allowed to create a user or not. Okay. But do remember, whenever running admin command, you will have to type this word, that is sudo user add Jim. I will type the password for Stephen. So what does this says? Warning, the home directory already exists. Okay, not copying a file from scale, creating mailbox files exist. I will try some other user. So let's check. So now you can see the Stephen user is allowed to create the user and it has the admin rights. So let's see what is next. For next 5 minutes, sudo will remember that you have been authenticated, so you won't be asked for your password. This works because the default etc sudo file on RHEL contains the following line, that is wheel all is equal to, okay, so then we will go into switching back to root. Let's go into the sudoers file. And it was said that uncomment this line, wheel all is equal to all. Okay, Let's find that line first. The simple way is to just put a question mark, then write the word. Okay, so the reason Stephen was allowed admin rights because this was already uncommented. But in your case, if you're doing it first time, you will have to, there will be a hash symbol, you will have to remove this hash symbol from here. So that is how the user, new created user, will get admin rights. That line enables all user in group wheel to run any command with sudo, but user will be asked to prove their identity with their password. So after logging out and back in again, you can verify that you are in group wheel by running the id command. So let's check. First I'll have to switch to Stephen, then I will check. So as you can see, the Stephen user is added in the wheel and it is shown over here. You can also configure sudo to not ask for a password to verify identity. For many situations such as for real server, this would be considered too much of a security. However, for developers running a RHEL virtual machine on their laptop, so this is a reasonable thing to do since access to their laptop is probably already protected by a password. So to set up this, you will have to edit etc sudoers, or you can create a new file, that is etc sudoers.d. The first is more straightforward, but the latter is easier to script and automate. So what do we have to change? So as root, run via sudo to edit sudoers. So one thing to note, vi sudo also can be used to go into etc sudoers file. The way we type etc sudoers and we go into this file, there is one more command that will take you into the file, that is vi sudo. So why it is, what is the difference in vi sudo is that it will validate the changes to the file. Okay, so this will validate the changes to the file. The default etc sudo file contain two lines, that is group wheel, the no password line is commented out. Okay, let's have a look. No, what was that password, passwd. So this line is commented. Yeah, as you can see, this line is commented with a hash symbol. So what we have to do is uncomment that line out with no password. When you are done, it should look like this. Okay, so what it says is we will have to comment this line with hash symbol. Commenting means whenever this file will be run, this line will be skipped. So that is what it means. Commenting means whenever the file will be running, it will skip the lines which are with hash symbol, and it is telling me to remove this. Okay, from here. So I will just save the file and let's check whether I am asked. I will have to first log in and then log out, then I will see whether it will ask for password or not. So to Stephen. Okay, so as you can see now, it has not asked the password for Stephen directly. It has given me one more way to check. I will do what I will do is another way, I will check it again whether if I take a new session then I have to put the password or not. So I have taken a new session now and let me check whether Stephen is asked to put the password or not. See, now this is a new session I have taken, a duplicate session, but still Stephen user is not asked to use the password. So that brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. If you like the video and this video was helpful for you, Do not forget to click the thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any new updates. Because your support will motivate me to make more videos and I'll be coming up with these type of videos very often. Alright then, see you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.